Welcome back on Emcure AICOG TV. I'm Dr. Swati Naik and I'm pleased to have with me Dr. Dilip Dutta sir. He is a director at Gynecology Institute of Clinical Excellence, Kalyani in West Bengal. He's a senior vice president of IMA Bengal branch in 2016 and 17. He's a dean of Indian Academy of Obstetrics and Gynecology in 2015. Vice chairman of ISAR Bengal 2015-17. He's author of 36 books. Sir, thank you so much for joining us on Emcure AICOG TV. The topic of our discussion is postpartum hemorrhage. I think the topic which is very close to your heart. So let me begin with my first question, like how common is this postpartum hemorrhage and what are the different causes of postpartum hemorrhage?
You know, it depends upon the condition of the patient, age and other factors. Most important cause is uterine atrophy, what a uterus is not contracted, or it may be traumatic, or it may be any deficiency in the blood, which is called DIC, or sometimes the placenta is retained after delivery, it may cause the PPH. So usually PPH after normal delivery is more than the PPH following cesarean section. The reason is there that in the normal delivery that happens mainly in the rural area where the placenta may be retained, where placenta may be partially removed, and that causes the PPH. So there is a problem we are facing each and everywhere in the rural setup. In the urban setup or any medical college, you don't find this one because so many people are there. So there is, we have to look after that one.
So in the setting of postpartum bleeding, how do I categorize my patient as a mild PPH, moderate PPH or a severe PPH? Is it the amount of the blood loss or directly it's a hemoglobin that is to be tested? On what grounds do I categorize my patient?
Now see, when we talk the PPH, postpartum hemorrhage means after delivery. At that time we have to define first what are the causes. So 80 to 90% causes due to uterine atrophy. What it was is not contracted. So if you take the uterine atrophy, say following cesarean section and following normal delivery, in the normal delivery we find the some bleeding is there, say 100 to 200, we say mild. Because you know during the pregnancy, the blood is diluted. If you lost even 100 or 200, you may be lost blood of 1 or 2 grams. So doesn't mean, but if it is more than 200 to 500, we call the moderate, and after 500, which leads to our problem like shock, any other things, then we definitely call it a severe PPH.
Sir, how do we manage this postpartum hemorrhage?
Now, it depends upon, you know, the causes. Now, if the cause is uterine atrophy, uterus is not contracted, so we have to give the drip and the drugs. Main drug is the oxytocin. Oxytocin you are using. Now we are using the oxytocin. It may be used by you given the IM, intramuscular or intravenous. Now who is using? Say in the skill transfer cases in the rural area, the women that are using the IM. Or we may give in the drip also, saline. We may use any saline you can give it. It will make the control. If it is not controlled, then we are using the misoprostol the drugs also. But I suggest for last 4 years, I am using the 10 amoxic acid and there is 1 gram IM very slowly for 6 minutes is better in addition to the oxytocin. There is we call the medical treatment. In the
I think WHO has also revised their guidelines recently on the role of tranexamic acid in the postpartum hemorrhage being to be used irrespective of the cause of the bleeding.
I only come in the 2017, but I used it in my books. I mentioned the tamoxifen should be given during all cesarean section cases, non-normal delivery before 5 years.
Oh,
so
nice.
I am very lucky in that my conception has taken by World Health Organization.
That's
really
that
I have
nice.
Written in many, I given many lecture in my books also.
So what is a placenta previa, with what proportion it does terminates into the postpartum?
Yes, it is my close of my heart. You know, for the placenta previa, I have advocated many techniques. Everyone knows my Dutta's innovative techniques.
Oh, nice.
Now, what is placenta previa? Now, normally, the placenta is above in the fundus of the uterus is above and baby is below. So when the baby is delivered, placenta delivered. In the placenta previa, placenta is below, baby is above.
Mm-hmm.
Now, see, imagine the, how much bleeding will come. Now, most of the death in India and outside also, all during the placenta previa. Now, everybody doing these techniques after bleeding occurs. I say why? I have done the preventive aspects. Say any girls or any woman is a primary first baby, she is a placenta previa. If she bleeds, they are removed the uterus. I say why? So I develop some techniques. What techniques? That is, during the cesarean section, normally what we'll do, we take the baby first, then we take the placenta, then we're giving that injection. But here what I'm doing, since the placenta is below, I take the baby first, then I'm giving the injection oxytocin, then I'm giving the temexic acid, is very much essential. Because after that, when the uterus is contract, I take the placenta, here bleeding will be less. So temexic acid, here is a 100% rules because the friable vessels are there, that will control by temexic acid. So I say the temexic acid is a must to tackle a case of bleeding following the major degree placenta previa, because placenta is below, when take the placenta, friable vessels are there, bleeds, temexic will help.
Sir, are you referring for a section for such cases? Are you referring to a cesarean section for such cases?
In all placenta previa, is a cesarean section is a must. And we call there are different types of placenta previa. Main placenta is a major degree placenta previa. That means type 3 and type 4, all the patient will die from that. But type 1 and type 2, you may tackle the normal delivery, but depending on the situation concern. But as you in a heart, the placenta previa in any woman, we are very much cautious. We, the obstetrician, are very much afraid of this, because all the pregnancy after cesarean section or even delivery in placenta previa, maximum death occurs because of bleeding. And then to prevent the bleeding, everybody remove the uterus, and that is the problem for us. So I say, why you remove? Because all the people develop the technique after bleeding occurs, after losing one or two
pints of the
blood with existing anemic woman, how is possible in India? So my friends in Christopher Billinch in London, he said that I am doing curative, you are Dr. Dutta doing the preventive. So I am the preventing from there, and that is I am telling the placenta previa message to each and everyone. You take the baby fast, then give the oxytocin, other drugs, temexic acid. When the uterus is contracted, then you take the placenta. Don't the baby at the same time placenta one time bleeds like anything. So this is my message to you. That is the placenta previa, no death. In my series still today, and of course that is why I got many prize and all these things. Innovative.
Congratulations for
thank
that,
you.
Sir, and thank you very much
thank
for
you.
Joining us on Emcure AICOG TV.
Yeah, thank you.
And sharing your very valuable views on the management.
I am also very happy. I am also very happy. Through your message, I am giving the message to my generation people. How can you prevent the maternal death lead caused by placenta, major degree placenta previa? Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir. Thank you very much.
Thank you.